for one in this best of three. Spenu on the blue side. All right, so what's the takeaway here? Last season, Captain Jack also played a lot of Kalista and was one of the first Kalista players here in Korea, actually, and doing a lot of work with that champion.
Yeah, he, of course, debuting that Runaz Hurricane build in professional matches in Korea.
So Kuzan plays most of the same champions that GBM does. They actually have a pretty large overlap in terms of their pool. Azir, I'm going to be going over to Kuzan, and there is the Kalista ban, as expected.
Yeah, on purple side, you generally always have to, especially in a professional match, because every AD carry's been vying for a hard carry game on that Kalista.
So where do you go with this? Chaser's been doing much better now in the Cinder Hulk meta, so you could take out a jungler from him. Now, I wouldn't prioritize Catch considering his performance hasn't been great even when he's had powerful junglers so
far.
Cassiopeia removed. So two bans against Kuzan already. Are they going to go for the triple mid ban and take away his LeBlanc as well?
I think you kind of have to at this point. You've locked yourself in unless you want to take the LeBlanc. I mean, Sasuke can play LeBlanc.
You'd have to first pick it though.
Right. And so that's the danger there. So that we might see them just ban it out.
Yeah, we have seen some first pick LeBlancs this season, but it just hasn't been quite as common. Gragas removed by Jhin Air. And they could set up a situation where if LeBlanc is first pick, they could get something like Alistar and a jungler of their choice.
Yeah.
That would be pretty nice for them.
I mean, they could take Alistar, Maokai, and then go forward from there. There's just so many ways to shut down the LeBlanc if it's first picked.
But at the same time, like you're saying, the two mid bans, if you don't ban LeBlanc, they're going to ban Bard. Wow, that's surprising because it's been in the interviews, Jhin Air has said that it's Sweets Bard that's drawing all these bans. So with Che in, interesting to see the Bard ban all the same. Che must also be good with that champion, as well as Jhin Air. Bard is such a team-based champion that if they have, as a team, have a specialty in Bard, the other players are going to know how to play around it really well.
Right. So you got to imagine that. I'm sure Che's also been practicing it quite a bit. He's everyone's used to playing with that champion. And so the last ban will be Alistar. I think that's not surprising at all. Alistar's such a high priority pick these days.
But with the Alistar ban, it does open up a LeBlanc
first pick. Yes, it does. Because now any support you pick will be able to get blown up.
Nautilus, not so much, but he's the only one.
Yeah. I guess Morgana support also, depending on how well you can ramp up. But much easier choices.
I think you go with the LeBlanc here, and especially after the Gragas Alistar bans, because those are both champions that reduce damage by percent, and they're not going to be available. So this is a pretty solid first pick from Spenu Sonic Boom.
And at that point, I do wonder if you just first pick that Nautilus, or if you just leave it open, because you could play Morgana, or you could just pick Morgana and just leave it open as a flex pick.
Yeah, we haven't seen Jhin Air run that in a long time. Sivir, obviously very strong because of the spell shield here and because you have Captain Jack on your team. So Sivir against the LeBlanc. Take Maokai here, Sivir, Maokai. Wait for the Nautilus later in the draft and then work with that instead.
Nocturne, probably not going to be the pick. Does have a spell shield, though.
All spell shields all the time. Everybody spell shields.
And then you get Morgana. Rengar being highlighted by Chaser, only 10 seconds left.
Chaser used to be a very good Rengar player, but I doubt we're going to see that. Rek'Sai
makes a lot more sense. I mean, sure, Sivir, Rengar, you've got that synergy, but the Rek'Sai having a little bit more to do comfortably in the early phases of the game.
So not a lot tipped here. You could go for the Nautilus takeaway. And they could look for a pick composition with the Evelynn as well. Lots of options here. I say you just go for the Sejuani and just have Catch press R instead of relying on him to be a force in the early game on the Evelynn, which is something that he just hasn't proven to be able to do as a player. And now, so you take the Nautilus away as well. Just go for the big front line and the bursty LeBlanc. See if you can pull out a win in that fashion.
Yeah, I mean, in that same vein, you have the Maokai, too, to consider. for the top lane, but you haven't seen the matchup in the top lane yet, so that is a bit of a danger. The Nautilus, though, oh, just gonna, okay, take the Rumble.
Well, those Sejuani Rumble ult combos can be incredibly deadly if executed properly, because there's just no way to get off the Equalizer, and you end up taking a significant amount of burn damage. And I'm not sure if Svenu will be in a good position to set those up, because that takes some really good communication and timing between the players, and there we go.
Yeah, I mean, this is expected. At this point, you take the LeBlanc after the Alistar, you take the Nautilus and the Maokai in that top lane to reduce that damage coming in, have that stronger front line. You have the Spell Shield on the Sivir, and now the mid lane can comfortably somewhat make a counter pick.
I'm not sure if they can actually feasibly play Vayne here. They do have some threat, but they may not have enough peel for Vayne to move around comfortably in these team fights. And with two targeted CC abilities, with Depth Charge and with Twisted Advance, I would be really nervous about playing Vayne, especially when it's backed up by a Sivir ultimate.
Yeah, with On the Hunt, then the Nautilus can continue with more CC. Jinx runs somewhat of the same issues, but you have your own traps, too, to at least deny some of that.
Range.
Yeah, and you've got, obviously, much longer range.
So, I also like it better with the combination of Rumble and Sejuani, because if you hit one of those ult combos and then also land a couple of crit rockets in there, Jinx is going to reset very easily.
Yes.
But it does rely, this composition relies so heavily on Catching Souls ultimates to function.
Yes.
If they miss those ultimates, Jinx is dead.
Yeah,
that's
Jinx
it.
Is dead. You can't really go in. But if they hit those and Jinx shoots her ultimate also with the Super Mega Death Rocket, then things could go really well for Svenu. So what's Kuzan's pick going to be here in the mid lane? Oh, the Lissandra getting locked in.
So that is a response to the Jinx.
Yeah.
And it's actually a response to the LeBlanc as well.
Yes.
As we know, Lissandra, a very good matchup into LeBlanc, because you can catch her during her distortions with Ring of Frost if she tries to trade with you. So it's been a pretty classic LeBlanc counter.
Absolutely.
And also deals with Jinx well. Now, Lissandra fell out of the meta because in the tanky meta, her targets for burst run out pretty quickly. And since you can't burst a jungler anymore, a lot of the supports have been tankier, like Alistar as well. And you know the mid laner's going to get a Zhonya's, and the AD carry will eventually get a QSS. You actually do have zero targets sometimes in the late game. And that burst damage just isn't quite high enough anymore, especially if you contrast it since the release of Luden's Echo with champions that can just proc Echo again and again and again, like Cassiopeia or Azir. So it's a bit of a risk. They don't have the best late game Jhin Air, but they will be very tanky and heavy crowd control. So if they can survive the ult combo, though, which, of course, the Lissandra ult gives you another way to survive, they can actually just grind it out over time. So
yeah, I think
this is a... I wouldn't normally like the Lissandra pick, but I really do like it here.
Yeah, I think it is a good way to round out the team. You can just look for the late game, which Jhin Air often does. Now, Svenu, they're looking for an explosive win in game one with this composition. Can they finally get the win they've been looking for all summer season? Let's find out as we kick off game number one. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. You know what I've noticed? Is that all the fans who cheered for Svenu were male, and all the fans who cheered for Jhin Air were female. Not sure why that split is happening in this matchup, but Svenu.
GBM just has that raw animal magnetism. Chobra. I'm surprised you don't know that. GBM's not even playing, but his pure sexual charisma just courses through the Jhin Air booth at all times.
Well,
chicks dig bow ties, man.
Oh, that's true. Makes sense.
Especially on Asian guys. That is one of the most OP things, is how good bow ties look on Asian men.
It's true.
It's amazing.
Can't agree. Bow ties are pretty great.
And so I don't look good at bow tie. I'm jealous.
But Asians don't look good in a lot of other fashionable choices, so I think it's a fair trade. And we'll just see three standards start from both sides. We are going to see Catch starting on his blue buff, but it doesn't look like the Spenu bottom lane is going to go for those Krogs. So Vivid will get some hits onto Che.
Oh,
just trade some damage, though.
Support wars. My favorite.
So intense. The Who's Hook hits harder.
Well, it's not fair because Vivid has an auto attack buff on his flay. So, what a jerk. Wins that battle.
Yeah, well, it's not going to matter too much. Everyone just back in lane. He's still going to get some hits in. Of course, the range helping quite a bit, too, on both. Also starting a little bit more tanky stats and regen, so Vivid gladly trading back and forth. Che, and it's a flay, and that'll nuclear for some extra hits. Che actually has to start watching out a little bit.
A lot of damage early on, of course. The advantage in this matchup does go to Jinx at level 1.
Yes.
There's really not a whole lot that Sivir can do. And then Jinx Sivir lane, because you do have the switcheroo or whatever the hell rocket thing is called. I don't know. I'm just here to watch her shoot rockets at Sivir, Chobra.
I think that's fine. Yeah, I think we'll start seeing that. Of course, later on, during team fights, Captain Jack will have a little bit more utility. And Captain Jack Sivir is always a pleasure to watch.
One of the first very famous Sivir players ever in League of Legends history. Known really as his signature champion, along with Graves and Ashe.
So Graves, the Graves, Lulu, Lustboy, Captain Jack lanes, those were pretty brutal.
Those were
the day.
back when Lustboy used to beat up TSM instead of being on them.
That's true. That is very true.
I miss those days.
Those were some fun times. Chase is just going to go ahead and take that Skull Crab. Very quiet start on both sides. Sasin, I mean, yeah, this is exactly why the Sandra is good. You go in for your own harass with a distortion, but you actually just get countered really hard. And there's the passive pop. Sasin, his distortion waiting for it. He has
nice.
To flash over.
Very good. Forcing that flash early on. That's one less tool that Sasin has for an all in. And Kuzan pretty handily winning this matchup. Back when Lissandra was big, this is one of the reasons why we didn't see so much, or as much LeBlanc, really. There was still LeBlanc being played, but it was riskier to first pick her. Of course, LeBlanc is going to do a lot more in terms of damage in the late game as Lissandra tapers off. But if you can get enough of an edge, you're in a good position.
Yeah, but the problem is, you know, the other thing we discussed is everyone picked against us a LeBlanc. I mean, who are you really going to pop? Yeah, if you catch Captain Jack unawares, that will definitely be a kill, but...
Maybe.
But it's Captain Jack.
Yeah, it's not... This is not a reliable composition, and Jhin Air did a good job of building against the LeBlanc as well.
Yes.
While simultaneously actually building against the combo coming in from Rumble and Sejuani.
Exactly.
Really, the question here is how do you play against Burst? And Jhin Air has an answer, and... That's why we see not so many burst compositions, because yes, if you can execute them well, they still work just fine, but the burden of outplay is on the burst composition.
Yeah. There's just a lot more mistakes you can make, and at the professional level, it's just whoever makes more mistakes, really, that often determines the game. But for now, no big mistakes being made, no reason for there to be any in this game so far, as both junglers are also just quietly farming away. Except for that small little show up in the mid lane forcing the flash.
We'll see what we can do, what we see from Chaser here, because again, he is that nearly 90% kill contribution, and this is his fifth best of five so far. Best of three, I keep saying best of five. Best of three, damn it. So far.
We know you just can't get enough League of Legends even with 4 days a week. You just need more games, Monty.
I just need to cast more than 7 best of threes a week. I don't. I love League of Legends, but there are limits, Chobra.
It's a pretty tight schedule. On the top lane, Grace is trying to shove in, and Sasin's still doing what he can. This time he gets a decent hit, but Kuzan is sick, so Sasin has to wait now before about going in all in, especially if Kuzan, I mean, if he's healthier or at least at even health, he could even just ult LeBlanc and just get a free kill there, making his own escape. Meanwhile, Nuclear seems to have been caught a little bit by Che, but Vivid with the flay will send them back. Nuclear will have to wait until the lane pushes up a bit to continue farming.
Oh, back and forth trading here. Between Soul and Trace. Taken away. I mean, Trace still really only playing two champions this season. Going back to that Maokai again.
And there's a flash and the ultimate coming from Kuzan. What a combo with the mid laner by Jhin'Air Green Wings. Good communication between Kuzan and Chaser right there.
Nice invade. And knowing they had that burst advantage. LeBlanc, no flash there to commit a little more. Does end up not using the ignite, but this will be transitioned straight into a dragon by Jhin'Air very early on into this game.
Yeah, a really good start for the Jhin'Air Green Wings. Shutting down catch, getting that kill. First, Kuzan not picking up the kill itself, but Kuzan also just going to go back after getting some poke in. Continue farming.
Kuzan really having a very strong debut, and I think what's impressed me the most about what we're seeing from Kuzan is his sense of awareness on the map. He really is there to help out when his team needs him and make some plays with good mechanics and good just spatial awareness.
Yeah.
And that's led him to that big KDA so far. Yeah, he's playing against Sasset now. And yeah, his first two games were against Crown, who definitely we wouldn't talk about in the same breath as players like Coco or Faker. But that said, for his first games, he's doing all right.
Yeah, I would agree. I mean, you know, even against these players, sometimes if you're not the strongest in your lane, then you might just even out at the very least and have the rest of your team carry onward. But he fills in some big shoes when he's playing in the mid lane instead of GBM. And a nice hook onto Nuclear. That's going to be some nice damage with the Boomerang Blade. The Lantern will save him, but that forces Nuclear to play way back in lane. And so the Jhin'Air Green Wings duo having a bit of an experience advantage with Captain Jack being level 6.
Yeah, Chaser using that Void Rush once again on the bottom side of the map. They have an option to dive this for sure. They are going to see Sejuani right now.
Yeah, there we go. The ping going down with the Tremor Sense.
Oh, it's just a ward. This here with a ward.
Oh, the ward. Yeah, okay. And Chaser goes ahead and he has.
I thought he could wait there, but his Cinder Hulk actually activates the creep. And now,
well, I mean, catch is really low, so Kuzan can just come in. There's a hook, so catch has to run away right into Chaser. Oh, man, the depth charge picks up the kill.
Kuzan gets double buffs, too.
Wow. Kuzan picking up the red buff as he goes over the wall for the AoE damage.
Well, Sasa's going to try and make something happen here, but you can see Trace just immediately backing off. Not wanting to commit to that. Kuzan didn't even have to use his ult right there, either.
Yeah.
So Ketch living up to his name in his own jungle for the second time. This is one of the reasons why I just have not been impressed by Ketch so far. He doesn't play with enough respect about where people could be on the map, and that causes problems with his ganks also.
Yeah, well, it's a crucial part of playing the jungle, and that's why it's one of the hardest roles to play in League of Legends sometimes, or especially in solo queue, right? So and you got to rely really on just the information you gather, since you're not always on the same wavelength in terms of communication with your teammates.
Okay, Sasin trying to be tricky right here, get some burst and maybe pick up a kill with that ignite, but Kuzan not really interested in that. Kuzan also starting this game with that Abyssal Scepter and with the Negatron already completed. Very unlikely that Sasin would be able to 100-0 him, particularly if Kuzan ults himself.
Yeah, it's just not going to happen. And but at the same time, Sasin, that's kind of his only way to get an edge right there, is to get those tricky picks. If you just stand in lane and you W, he's going to see you distortion in, he's going to freeze you up with Ring of Frost and go forward from there. Che gets caught as Catch shows up in the bottom lane. Now Glacial Prison is available. There's the play and the Glacial Prison. There's a Super Mega Death Rocket. Can they get the kill onto Captain Jack? Not going to be enough as Captain Jack runs away with Summoner Heal.
That was a good setup.
Yeah.
Spanu. That was all very smoothly communicated, and especially Vivid getting the flay on the grouping of Captain Jack and Che right there to keep them in, knowing that Che's ultimate was down, so there wasn't going to be a lot of counterplay available for the Jhin'Air Green Wings. So they have a good response. Lock them up with CC, start getting that Jinx rolling, which can be so important.
Yeah, the Avarice Blade now there for Nuclear, just trying to ramp up a little bit more. And of course also going for that wave clear with the Static Shiv.
Well, Chaser, not too many ganks so far, mostly focusing on shutting down the enemy jungler, even though he does have kill pressure in topside.
Chain's been caught again with the trash, but Vivid was a bit low, so they're afraid of going all in. Of course, the ultimate now in favor of Che. They don't want Nuclear to get caught with the depth charge, doesn't have a spell shield himself. Wait patiently. Boomerang Blade getting double hits onto Nuclear.
They have to be really careful. They don't just get Sivir ulted right here.
Yeah, Sivir ult depth charge. They can just continue following in. Kuzan takes a small hit against Sasan, but he's not too worried. Sees Cash clearing that ward, so he's going to play it a little bit further back after shoving this one in.
Jazer looking for a gank right here. Ping's going down onto Trace in the top side. Trace has a pink ward in the brush. So try and keep things pushed up and make sure he denies vision so Soul is afraid of trading with him. It's actually very smart.
Yeah, and he's going to deny that ward once again after evening out. Neither player was really comfortable with clearing their each other's wards until the minions were cleared, and Trace gets that advantage. Mid lane has been steadily in favor of Kuzan, now with the CS lead also, and here we go. Chaser moving on towards the top lane. See the pings back onto Kuzan. Looks like they don't want to give too many tells of Kuzan disappearing from the lane, but I think Soul already catches on. You also have the bottom lane missing too. There's just too many options. But Kuzan shows up back in the mid lane, and here's the Void Rush back into the top lane.
Here comes the dive.
Oh man. Oh, he's been spotted
by the Wolf Spirit, so not going to get too much done, but Deep Ward's in all the same. They're at the blue buff. Blue buff has spawned. They may try and steal right here. It looks like they're just going to trade in the end. Soul doing a good job of playing back right now, but at the same time, so let's talk about this pink ward at the top side, because that's actually very important. So as we were seeing earlier tonight in the Rumble versus Maokai matchup, if Rumble can play with no respect, he can just shut down Maokai. You can really play very aggressively. But if you're afraid of being ganked, you absolutely can't do that on Rumble, which keeps the matchup in check and in balance. But when you have that pink ward there, Rumble can't walk up because he's so scared constantly of that lane gank coming in.
Right. Oh, and there's the flash of the depth charge and the Lissandra ultimate. Sasan just gets locked up, cannot move.
They're still going here with the Sivir ult.
Yeah, I mean, on the oncoming in, but only Captain Jack getting that move speed. Here we go, everyone else speedily running through in the last second of it. There's the box. Che, can he get the hook? He has the angle, and he's not going to hit Vivid. Vivid narrowly dodges that one, but Nuclear left all alone. Chase just trying to deny that lantern. Yeah, Nuclear doesn't have an answer for that one. Meanwhile, Vivid got caught because of that. Who's on charging forward? Excuse me. Glacial Prison and Flay, though, he got a little too eager at the lantern shield and the tower shield, helping Vivid stay alive.
Yeah, nice return kill right there. Kuzan got too greedy.
Yeah.
His job was to prevent the Sejuani ult from being used on his teammate while they dove Jinx and locked him up under the turret. All he had to do was zone out right there. He got super greedy without his ultimate or without flash available and was punished for it just with a quick Sejuani ult and a flay to pick him up the turret damage. So a little bit too, that's a kind of a impulsive solo queue mistake that you would make right there instead of just calmly letting your teammates kill the AD carry, take out the turret, and then maximize your advantage.
Well, either way, Jhinnar Greenwing still having a healthy advantage, about 2.5k gold, a little bit extra. Che is roaming about, getting some vision for his teammates. They'll be waiting for that second dragon.
Third dragon, Spender took one.
Oh, third dragon.
Yeah, we didn't see it, but it happened.
Yeah, they got it during that top dive just right before, and Kuzan just picking up the blue buff, going right back to lane.
Buff King Kuzan.
Yeah, I mean, he's had a lot of buffs this game. Stole that red buff earlier, stole the enemy blue buff. But Spinu also putting in slightly deeper wards after everyone went back from the generic groomies to just keep tabs on Chaser. Chaser clears out one, and here's the pink ward. He goes for a shot, doesn't find it, but the hook not going to hit either. So Chaser now knows that someone was there. He'll put down his ward to get some vision over the ramp.
Trace actually just finishing the Spirit Visage here. That surprises me a little bit that he would go that far into a magic resist item instead of switching it up and going for a Righteous Glory to snowball their advantage, particularly that because Jhenaire's really looking at that strong mid game with Lissandra and Sivir, you do want to make sure that you get the fights you want during that time period. So
catch over the wall. He's going to get spotted with a ward right there. The Raptor buff helping him clear that one, but he's just going to have to Arctic Assault over the wall because otherwise the tower will be gone. Was looking for an angle, and if Vivid had hit that hook onto Captain Jack, maybe they would have jumped in, but Jack standing right behind the minions also has that spell shield.
I don't think he was that worried.
Yeah. I mean, it was really just Cash looking for the rare occasion that he could find a hit with the Glacial Prison. Sasan also was waiting around the corner, but the generic Green Wings playing very carefully where they do need to and denying those opportunities for surprise picks by Spenu.
I like how Sol has played a very measured game. He's fallen behind, but he hasn't taken any risks in the top side that were necessary. He seemed to have his eye on the mini-map this entire time, and just kind of played it back when he needs to. Eventually, he's going to have to group, but he'll be fine just farming out for a little while and trying to catch back up in that creep score.
Absolutely. Now, still about, say, oh, there we go, 2 minutes for the Dragon. I was thinking around 2 minutes, and Generic Green Wings, they did shove out that bottom lane, but theirs also got shoved out. But right now we do see Captain Jack going down to push it up even more to have a little bit more breathing room to get some vision and then shove down the tier one in mid. And Spenu sees that, but they're moving all the way up top. So Trace saw some people moving out of the mid lane, doesn't really see anyone else, decides to hold back.
He doesn't want to be here. Nuclear's there, but he has no armor.
Yeah. Kuzan not taking really any damage from Sasan unless it's a full combo. Yeah, Trace really needs to watch out. So Spenu responding correctly to how the lane ended up. I mean, they saw the bottom lane pushing too, so they decided, hey, send Sol back, get him some farm. He is at level 11 though, so he has that second level in the ultimate. Now 1 minute left until a dragon.
Yeah, Chaser and Che working very well together right there, just in case there was going to be a dive onto this armorless Maokai in the top lane. They were there right at the Krux, waiting to see if they could make some sort of counterplay. Now, back down to the bottom side, minion wave pushing towards Spenu Sonic Boom, and 45 seconds until Dragon. It's just been a very controlled game from Jhenaire.
Absolutely. Jhenaire Green's Kuzan not taking any chances after he clears up that one minion. Jumps backwards. Scuttlecrab also being taken 30 seconds right before the dragon spawns. He'll still be there while they're doing the dragon 2 for that movement speed buff.
Yeah, Che backing off wisely as Sonic Boom members start collecting in the bottom side of the river without taking out that pink ward. But they have the crab control right now. And yeah. Kuzan coming back into lane. Got his Zonya's Hourglass. That's going to be a very important
wow.
item in this next fight.
Yeah, he's all set up for team fights at this point. Now, Trace is already here. We saw Sol moving down, then decided to rely on the teleport. Captain Jack gonna go ahead and trigger the dragon. Trace is tanking it a little bit. Here comes the teleport from Sol, and the equalizer's up every skill available. Meanwhile, Kuzan actually gets caught first, Vivid with the lantern, but he actually brings Sol in, and Sol just gets caught with the Ring of Frost. Meanwhile, catch all the way up front. There's the Glacial Path, doesn't go over the wall, but there is still the Zonya's coming in. Chaser is gonna be able to run out. Nuclear gets the reset though, and he gets the second crit onto Captain Jack. He's just charging forward, and the chain is gonna get the snare onto Che. Nuclear going for the third one. Sasan picks that one up, and what a turnaround by Spenu Sonic Boom.
Yeah, they got the equalizer into that choke on the side, and Kuzan couldn't mop up kills fast enough in that team fight, so Nuclear was able to get a sustained amount of damage based off of Ketch's ultimate. And now they're going to get the dragon and the tower, so that'll just about even us up here in terms of gold.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, so take a look at this. Great catch onto Kuzan by Vivid. Kuzan not respecting that ward that was just placed over the wall. Captain Jack actually flashes into that equalizer, and even though they take down Sol, the damage has been done onto their carries. And Trace is sitting down there, not really able to zone out against Nuclear just because he doesn't have that armor yet. I'm really questioning this Maokai build from Trace, investing so much into that Spirit Visage early on.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, sure, it is double AP, but you didn't really need to finish it as your first core, and it definitely isn't paying off.
Absolutely, get the Merc Tress, get the Cowl, but get something else too. But that was great from Sonic Boom just to divide the carries off of the rest of the team, and they were able to hit so much damage because they hit both Kuzan and Captain Jack with the Equalizer.
Yeah, and now Jenner Greenwing's trying to pressure down this Tier 1 in the opposing mid lane, but they don't get it just yet, so Spin is still sitting happily in the mid lane advantage. Now the top lane Tier 1 left for the Jenner Greenwings, mid here for the Spin Sonic Boom.
Now this is where it starts to get scary for Jenner.
Assault over the wall. Assassin trying to get some damage onto Captain Jack. Not gonna pop the sigil though.
Yeah, how far is Spenu gonna be willing to push this? They have a slow push minion wave in the top side, so eventually somebody from Jenner is going to have to go up there and deal with it. We see Captain Jack going for the red buff at the moment.
Yeah, he's just gonna pick it up. Lots of wards by Spenu Sonic Boom all over the map. Sense trying to keep some tabs on where Spenu moves next. They're not gonna go too far. Meanwhile, Nuclear has been shoving up that top lane though, so they're standing between mid and top, looking for an angle, ward over the pit. But Jenner Greenwings also catches sight of that with their own ward in the pit. And Captain Jack all alone for now, so he has to watch out. Doesn't want to get caught out by the Equalizer, so he's just going to get shoved out by Soul charging forward. Meanwhile, Trace is pushing up the bottom lane, and Spenu, they don't have a teleport, so they either have to commit to this or all back, and I think at this point it's too late to just back, so they're trying to commit to this one.
Huge wave, though.
And the Equalizer, all right, Captain Jack uses Spell Shield to avoid the hook, but that means he's out of commission for a little while. Trace coming in with the teleport, and they'll save the Tier 2 and top. The condition in bottom lane was a pretty big wave, and is it going to go down? Doesn't look like it, not just yet.
Very, very close, though, and I'm a bit surprised that Trace TP'd in there, or at least completed the TP instead of just canceling it, considering that Spenu backed off pretty readily, which was enough to kill the large minion wave and pretty much end the threat on that tower. But goes through with it anyway.
Yeah, he'll still get the farm in the top lane, but didn't get the tier 2 in bottom, so Jenner Greenwings backing off themselves. Kruvuf just spawning for Assassin on the blue side.
Yeah, they need to, Jenner, they need to really get it together right here, because falling behind with this Lissandra isn't something that's going to treat them very well. They should have an advantage in terms of creating picks with the Sivir and LeBlanc and Rek'Sai mobility. So they need to focus on getting those wards down and continuing to target people one by one with the Lissandra, because that LeBlanc is going to be far scarier in late game teamfights than the Lissandra is. And that's a major consideration right now. It's a lot harder since the removal of DFG to do damage as Lissandra if you want to go that way in the late game.
Yeah, you are just serving a lot more of a kind of AoE and utility purpose in later team fights. I mean, you can still do decent damage, it's just that it's spread across multiple people. Meanwhile, Assassin going to be looking to target just one person and delete them first before starting the rest of the team fight.
Spenu's warding's very good though. Four pings on the map right now. They're doing a good job of controlling the ward line well in advance of the dragon spawn, and they have the advantage in dragon stacks already.
Yeah, and they all have the items they wanted at this point too, so none of them have to go back and risk just losing that ward line. Now they're just going to shove up that bottom lane, cutting off a little bit of that back off from the jungle so they can push it up to the tower. Sivir should be able to clear it out just fine for now.
And Spenu getting everything they want. They have TP advantage on this next dragon. Soul has pressure in the top side. They have pressure in mid. They have pressure in bottom. Everything is going their way. They should be able to take this next dragon, barring some sort of catastrophe. But that's the thing, is we've seen Spenu in this position before. And when I say barring some sort of catastrophe, the catastrophe has always seemed sort of inevitable with them, where they hold it. They can only hold it together for so long.
I do agree. So we'll see if they can. They've changed a little bit now that we come in after the first couple weeks of the summer season. Nuclear still just farming up quietly and patiently. And Spin still trying to just keep control of the vision on that bottom side. Now it's been pretty well shared because of the lack of pinks and scans to clear out wards from both sides. and Sasin. Just holding ground in mid lane too. They don't want to give that up for free while they go for a trade.
Rumble should absolutely just push this. There's no reason for him to recall right now when they have that pressure right at the tier 2 turret and Trace has no TP. So they can start the dragon just fine. As soon as they see two people, they're going to commit to this on the top side. Instead, Trace just used glory.
Yeah, he's not catching up just yet. He has his flash, but how much does he want to commit to this? We just saw the flash come out from Soul. Soul trying to run away with the shield. It might be just enough, but Chaser comes up for the catch, and the tier 1 is gone here. So dragon already taken for Svenu. And that's a three-man gank. Yeah, they're fully committed to this one. They should be able to get it one way or another. Now, how does Svenu react to this one? Three members gone. The entire front line gone from the Jhinnir Green Wing. So they're just going to try to shove up this bottom lane. The minions are here. Just a small way for now. Here comes the teleport from Trace. And that actually forces Svenu to back up right away.
But they keep having to use this teleport to save Tier 2 towers because Jhinnir is not managing their side waves very well to prevent these pushes from taking place. If there are three people, if there's one guy on the top side and the rest of the team is at that dragon, why is there a minion wave pushing at a tier 2 turret? It should be the rest of the members of Jhinnir's job to push those waves out while the dragon is being taken, while you know where they are and it's perfectly safe to do so, so they can't just simply transition objective to objective like that.
Yeah, Jhinnir and Green Wings are pretty much playing reactionary League of Legends all throughout. At this point, 28 minutes in, they do finally get the tier 1 of mid, evening out the tower score, but it's a 3-1 dragon advantage for Svenu.
Yeah, bit rough for Jhinnir after they had such a good early game trying to shut him down with the kills on to catch, but ever since that point, Sonic Boom just been playing the map a lot better.
Yeah, and catch just being there for the main objectives, being able to secure that for his team.
Early QSS from Nuclear, but considering there's no armor on the enemy team, why not get that item? You don't need that Last Whisper right now. You just need to stay alive so they can't burst you with the Lissandra and Maokai. So great buy, really.
Yeah, and also just to get away right away, even from that Nautilus after that passive, if you really feel the need. So a really good pickup, especially after the three kills. He had a little bit of extra gold there. Won't be too far behind. We also just see that pickaxe coming in for Captain Jack at the moment. It's a good investment. Wow, they're targeting Soul once again. They know the flash is down. There's a Righteous Glory. There's a slow. And Soul just doesn't have an answer to this. Equalizer goes down again, but you know you're not picking those kills up.
Are you going to lose the Baron, though?
Yeah, well, he's just trying to draw out enough time. There's a Void Rush coming in from Chaser. Trace finally gets the kill, and it looks like the Baron does have to
be
stopped.
That's so risky. Yeah, wow. You kill Soul, but you don't have a TP. You have the Void Rush, but there's a possibility that the Baron just goes down right there, and they don't get it. Captain Jack somehow finds some damage onto the mid lane.
Yeah, the Jhinnir Green Wings, by targeting Soul hard during the split push, now taking advantage of the situation just a little bit, gets a slight lead once again.
And this is where a team that has more experience than Sonic Boom would be really punishing Jhinnir for what they're doing. But Jhinnir, I think, preying on their inexperience in some of these situations to get kills without trading any objectives in situations that they really have no right doing.
Yeah, well, they took down Soul twice. He doesn't really have an answer to those. And there's no tier one, so he can't push out as safely anymore. We'll see how Spinner reacts to that one after two times. Have they learned their lesson? Of course, he did get the dragon on the first attempt. No Baron this time. Green Wings able to clear out just fine. Void Rush coming in right next to that mid lane. Securing the Raptor is also making sure that no shenanigans come through from Svenu.
Chaser's still with 100% kill contribution in this game.
Wow. Really all over the map. I mean,
he's actually increasing his current 89.1% kill contribution for Jhinnir in this match. And you can see how crucial he is to Jhinnir's ability to make plays.
Yeah, absolutely. Svenu looking for a catch here. I mean, they know that the Jhinnir Green Wings have been targeting Soul, but considering none of them are seen, I think Jhinnir Green Wings are aware that something might be going on. Sure, they could have all gone back. Sure, they could be farming their jungle, but the map does look pretty empty. They haven't watched through any of the other wards.
I mean, I don't think they care what's going on as long as the Baron's not being done.
That's true.
We have hide in a, make your enemy hide in a brush forever. They can't do anything, so it's a victory for you all the same, and they have the information they need right now. Gray's going to get a lot of farm in that bottom side, finally starting to build towards that Frozen Heart.
Yeah, that's going to matter a lot against someone like a Jinx. The aura obviously helps a lot. It's a lot of armor. The mana helps a lot. Here is it on the hunt once again. He's trying to just teleport out. And, oh, he will get it. The knockup not hitting Chaser right outside of range.
Wow, that was
super
really close. I'm actually very surprised that the knockup didn't go down right there.
Yeah, I thought he was going to hit, but it looks like he was right outside of the brush. And here's the hook on Trace. Not going to hit, even if it did. I mean, Trace not too worried about getting bursted out by a LeBlanc right now after that early Spear Visage. So Soul's Teleport has now been forced. And, I mean, like
that's
you
huge.
Mentioned, yeah, Monty, I think this is the big point, is that if you're going to have Soul constantly split push, then, and he can get caught like that, you have to take advantage of it. But at this point, it's come down to Soul having to use his summoners just to escape, which means Jinnar Greenwings do get a passive advantage from that.
Yeah, and now they have that TP advantage too, which... with this kind of composition that can create picks so easily, can't be underestimated. And also just because Jhin'er is a more veteran team and can play the map better, as we've seen in the last few minutes, that they can make more of that ability.
Yep, so Svenu just trying to clear out some of the wards leading into this Dragon Pit. Vivid takes a poke from the Boomerang Blade. Svenu just walking around. Catch has been standing still. He tries to start forward. He doesn't hit the freeze onto Kuzan. Sasin goes in and decides he can't get the kill at that point. So Glacial Prison has been used. Kuzan escaping death right there. Scuttle Crab in favor of Svenu, but they can't start the dragon now. It's too late to take that risk with all of the Jhin'er Greenwings members there and healthy.
Trying to clear out some wards right now, Jhin'er. They should want to fight this.
Yeah, well, I mean, Svenu also kind of had to go for it. Jhin'er Greenwings, can they go in for the steal and the fight? And Catch really wants to secure this dragon at this point. I mean, both teams have to commit to this dragon. Who's going to get the smite battle first? And it's going to be Nuclear with the kill on that one. And they lock up Kuzan. Kuzan has to use his ult on himself. Vivid flashes out. Catch all the way up front gets targeted. Oh, and the super mega death rocket. He timed it, but the Zonius comes in. So Nuclear doesn't get a reset. He's getting targeted by Trace. He'll still be able to get that kill and escape as Sasin helps him with that one. Shut down gold on Trace because of the way they've been targeting Soul. But it's a 2-1 kill score for Jhin'er Greenwings, but Svenu does secure the dragon.
Yeah.
4 stacks now.
They're sitting at those 4 stacks, and Jhin'er should have been much more decisive about that dragon fight. There wasn't a Glacial Prison there. They had everything they needed to fight that. But Trace, you could just see him melting to Nuclear because he just doesn't have, or didn't at the time, have that Frozen Heart.
Yeah.
His build delayed him so much when he needs to be the one getting on top of Jinx and being able to tank her.
Yeah, I mean, he was able to lock her down, but especially with Sasin's help there too, with extra CC, Nuclear could just kite that Maokai a little bit further away from the fight. Props to Kuzan, of course, with that immediate Zonius to dodge the Super Mega Death Rocket. That could have been even more disastrous for Jhin'er Greenwings.
Yeah, this is still a really good situation for Svenu Sonic Boom on the cusp of that fifth dragon stack, now starting to get some potions to see them through the end of this game. And will this be Svenu's first game win of the season? They're knocking on the door.
Well, it'd be a pretty impressive one. And Soul now grouping up, doesn't have that teleport, hanging out with the team. And Sasin gonna catch Che out just a little bit. There's a hook, and he still gets snared. There's a hook coming in from Vivid. Oh, he actually jumps in. There's the play, but Captain Jack right there. And there's a Glacial Prison onto Kuzan. Kuzan gonna get caught, but he uses his old ultimate right now. Nuclear in the back. Sasin just in the back all the way, trying to run away. Nuclear gets caught. Eventually goes down to Trace. There's no peel for him at that point. And Sasin also gonna get caught. No, he's gonna double distortion away.
Well, they finally found the right team fight for them because Kuzan was able to zone out very well and was the only person really hit by the majority of that Equalizer and Glacial Prison combo. And now that Trace has the
Frozen Heart finish, he was able to deal with Nuclear a whole hell of a lot better as well.
Absolutely. He was just staying there tanking, waiting for his teammates to come through. Of course, a lot of CC backwards too, keeping Nuclear even closer to the fight than before. The Baron goes in favor of the generic Green Wing.
So it looks like they have a good shot, right? Che gets targeted out really early right here, but Kuzan, he's the only one who gets hit by the Glacial Prison. So that AoE not used very efficiently, and then he's able to keep himself alive with the combination of his ult and the Zhonya, so there are no resets. Trace gets in that choke and absolutely zones out the carries from the fight. Zossin has to use his ult to double distortion his way out of harm. And that's a Baron for Jhenair. And this is what we're talking about with this suspended Sonic Boom team. They put up similarly good fights against CJ and against SKT. But when it comes to actually closing the game, they falter.
Yeah, well, they'll still have another shot after this Baron buff ends. Because they do, they are sitting on the cusp of that fifth Dragon stack, and that's going to be just as strong of a buff. We'll see if they can make it happen, though. Like you mentioned, the Frozen Heart now finished for Trace. That's a big tool against Nuclear. He can't run Rampant anymore, even with that QSS.
Yeah, they keep moving towards this top lane as well. Looks like they want to deal some damage with this big wave Nuclear on the other side of the map. Getting a red buff at the moment while Captain Jack pushes forward with the help of his static Shiv. And here we go. They should have not too many problems taking out this turret right now. Jack gonna get auto attack or two.
Sasan just going in, trying to clear the wave while forcing Jack to back off. But it's gonna go down eventually. Tier 2 and bottom going down alone to the double cannon minions and Chaser there with the Baron buff. And Spenu, I mean, I don't know if they can defend this Tier 2 and top either, especially if Chaser comes up to join.
Now, as soon as they see Jinx in the mid lane, they should just dive this turret if they can.
Nuclear prioritizing the mid lane tier 2, and he's going to clear that wave just fine. The minion wave now pushing up in tier 2 at top, and look at that. The champions don't even need to hit it. The minion's doing the job for them.
Chaser doing a very good job of split pushing right now against this Rumble, using that tankiness that he's managed to get. Has that passive damage as well with the Sunfire Aura just to help push those minion waves a tad now. Smart of Jhenair, back off right now. You have a gold advantage. Don't give them any way back into it. Secure the fifth dragon for yourself, or the second dragon in your case.
Right.
Take it away from Spenu, because that is their final hope of really coming back into this game, and you need to get the vision control down, set up, before that happens.
Yeah, they're right there. And now Spenu doesn't have their vision deep into the enemy jungle either, so they can't march forward freely toward. And there's On the Hunt coming in. Jhenair Greenwing's looking for an answer. Oh, but here's the flank from Trace. He's not going to go on just yet. There's the depth charge. Do they go for the dive? And we're going to see Catch come all the way back at the hook. Back onto Trace. Can they kill him first? But Equalizer goes down to divide the enemy team. But Trace is so tanky. Just no damage coming in. LeBlanc looking for an answer from the flank. But he can't find the angle to go in and burst Captain Jack down.
Still a lot of ults used there from Jhenair. Two pretty important ones. And just, well, Box and Equalizer also to add Glacial Prison. Never mind, they trade very effectively for that. They'll be perfectly happy to fight this dragon afterwards. We'll see if they want to actually maybe risk a 50-50. Sasin has been sussed out by the Tremor Sense.
Oh man, he's really not gonna find a good answer here. Chilling Smite used on to Sasin, but that means the Smite has been used. So Spenu was already hitting that dragon, but there we go. Nuclear all the way in the back of Trace, zoning out three members once again. Catch has to Arctic Assault over the wall, and there's a hook onto the trap, but there's the flash forward from Kuzan. He zones out three members. QSS used by Nuclear to escape there. Ring of Frost, and Kuzan with the Zhonya denying that damage. There's a flash from Soul. There's a hook coming in from Vivid just to keep his teammates alive, but Soul will be cut off. Can they catch any more members? Zap not going to connect. Oh, the Lantern! It does save him. I thought that last boomer might be coming in and Catch. Can he get away? Chaser putting down some good slows onto this one, and there's the hook onto Catch. The Equalizer back already, but not going to be the answer. Meanwhile, Sasin got caught looking for another sneaky angle from the Psy, but he can't find it before Trace gets to him, and he's just trying to distort back up. Whoa! What a kill from Sasin. Nope. He does eventually get caught, though.
Burns the Ignite onto Che. Catch is dead, so they should be able to secure this dragon unless there's some sort of freak smite accident. Chaser should have a smite up by the time this goes down. They're going to need to attempt a rocket steal.
Yeah,
it's not up.
Not up, and there's the depth charge just to keep Soul away. So teleport used without any success.
Wow, well, Kuzan, you can see just the damage and the usefulness of this Lissandra in the late game in comparison to the LeBlanc just really isn't there. As soon as the Zhonya is down and as soon as the ultimate is down, she really can't do much of anything. While LeBlanc can continue to bounce all over the map and continue to threaten and get kills. Some longer cooldowns on those abilities and those items to make the challenge of playing Lissandra a little bit greater when you talk about timings.
Absolutely.
And Jhenair, are you going to go for another Baron here?
Only a minute left. Trace is clearing out that top lane. We'll see if they find an angle there. No vision there around the Baron pit for either team just yet, though.
Yeah, they're still taking a look, however. And can they make this one work? Could be a very slow setup for some of these wards. And there's a very large minion wave down there,
yeah,
inching its way closer to the inhibitor turret, but they'll have plenty of time to deal with that and possibly contest the Baron. Baron's still dangerous for Jhenair to do in spite of their lead, just because of the massive number amount of AoE as well as the Jinx resets. That could turn a Baron fight sour very quickly.
Yeah, Nuclear does have to start moving up right after this wave, though. Otherwise, Jhenair Greenwings will be way too well set up. He's going to actually port back. And Chaser was looking for a catch onto the Jinx, but not going to find it. She stopped moving right as he got there with the Tremor Sense. There's a Bloodthirster for Nuclear, just getting a little bit more sustain in these team fights.
Yeah, nice pickup for sure. Right before this fight is about to break out. Jax had that Banshee's Veil for a while now. And against the double AP composition, it is serving him well. He is up there at 6 items. 43
yeah.
minutes into this game. Spenu's Sonic Boom really turning this into more of a close match than you might have imagined.
Absolutely. I mean, they had that really good early game, and here we go, clearing out the vision. Sonic Boom moving swiftly through the area around the Baron pit. Now they're the ones set up in front, but they can't hit it first either.
All right, so Jhenair has decided that what they're going to do is just punish their lack of teleport right now to split push and force the issue. Not a good Rek'Sai tunnel choice. There is
yeah.
one by the red buff, it's not great.
So I think Spenno, seeing that, decides, all right, well, let's try to force the Rek'Sai to leave. But actually, the Jhenair Greenwings just forced Spenno to leave the Baron pit with the poke coming in and the threat of just charging in with that Maokai up front.
And if you're a veteran team, this is one of the best ways to take advantage, is to put the other team in a high-pressure decision-making situation because they frequently flounder.
Yeah, well, Rek'Sai deciding, hey, I still don't need to go just yet. I have faith in my team. There we go. Spenu's really chunking down this Baron. It's a third way through. There is a Void Rush coming in, and the box comes in, but there's a Depth Charge onto Soul. The Equalizer not doing too much, but it does lock up Trace. There's a Glacial Prison, but an instant double kill coming in for Kuzan as Nuclear is left to fend for himself in enemy territory.
Everybody's been doing this against Spenu's Sonic Boom. Just you put him in the Crucible,
oh,
you see
man.
If they can actually survive it, and now Chaser just returning. What a great game from Chaser, though, overall, because he's the one who's been forcing all these decisions. He's the one who's been ganking Soul and making them panic without taking objectives cross-map, and he's the one who's been split-pushing down to the last second right there, getting the inhibitor turret. He's also the one that has 100%
yeah.
kill contribution in this game.
19 kills, and he's been part of every single one.
Fantastic jungle performance.
Really well done, and the Jhenair Greenwings now will be pushing in for the win against the Nexus turrets at 45 minutes. Jack a little bit hungry for more action, but the Jhenair Greenwings start the match with a win in the first game.
And I really feel bad for Spenu's Sonic Boom because they are better than their record suggests. And they've had such a hard schedule to start this
yeah.
season that I'm very curious when we see them play teams like IM and Anarchy, how they're going to do, because they show such great control in the early and mid game. Their vision is good. It's just they fall apart when some really tough decisions have to be made, and they just get out mind game by their opponents like we saw right there.
Yeah.
But as they grow and they learn how to deal with some of these situations better, they're going to be able to actually snowball these games into wins. So maybe by the end of the season, we can see them start taking a game or two off of teams like Jhenair.
Very true, and that's what we saw in the spring season. A lot of these newer rosters struggled a little bit in the first half, and then they climbed back in. I mean, KT now definitely